In part 7 of our lesson on graphs of sine and cosine, you will be sketching a sine function. In this example, we have to sketch one complete period of the graph of y is equal to negative 2 sine of 3x. Now we know the domain for the sine function is negative infinity to positive infinity. The period we can find by computing 2 pi divided by b, and we know that in this case b is the coefficient of the argument, so it is 3. So we know the entire cycle is going to take place in a time period of 2 pi over 3. So this is going to be a horizontal compression, meaning the sine wave is going to go faster. It'll be done sooner than normal. The amplitude is the absolute value of A. So we're going to get the absolute value of negative 2, which is equal to 2. So this will be a vertical stretch by a factor of 2. We also have to be aware of the fact that because that is a negative out front, we know that means the graph is going to flip over the x-axis. Now the range of sine starts out, we know, as negative 1 to 1, and then it will be transformed by the fact that the amplitude is equal to 2, so the range of our graph is going to be from negative 2 to positive 2 after the vertical stretch. Now, just a reminder that you have to multiply by the amplitude here, not A. So I don't take negative 1 times negative 2 and this suddenly becomes positive 2, and 1 times negative 2 where this becomes negative 2, because then this interval notation wouldn't make any sense, because you would be saying positive 2 is less than negative 2. The range gets multiplied by the amplitude, not A. And remember, the amplitude is the absolute value of A. Next, we have to solve the inequality for the new cycle, and we know to solve that inequality, we're doing 0 is less than or equal to the argument, which is bx, is less than or equal to 2 pi. So in our case, we're solving 0 is less than or equal to 3x is less than or equal to 2 pi. To get the x all by itself, we know we're going to divide by 3 all the pieces of the inequality. So our inequality becomes 0 is less than or equal to x is less than or equal to 2 pi over 3. And this checks out with what we said our period is going to be. Now, just a reminder that once we start doing horizontal shifts, this value isn't going to match this value, but the length of this interval will match the period. So we're learning one method that we can use throughout the whole semester to make our graphs. Okay, so we know that our cycle is going to start at 0. And it's going to end at 2 pi over 3. And now we're ready to find the 5 key points of the graph. We know that our starting value is 0, and our ending value is 2 pi over 3. So now we have to find the midpoint of those two numbers, which this one's pretty easy to see. Half of 0 plus 2 pi over 3 is going to be pi over 3. If you can just see that in your head, I want you to just write the answer down. If you don't see that in your head, that's okay. Then just go ahead and write out the calculation so you don't make a mistake. So as we said a minute ago, half of 2 pi over 3 is going to be pi over 3. Now to find the quarter point, we know we have to do the midpoint of these two. So we're going to add them up and divide by 2. So 0 plus pi over 3. Dividing by 2 is multiplying by a half, and we see that this is pi over 6. Then to find the 3/4 point, we're going to find the midpoint between the midpoint and the endpoint. So we're going to add those up and divide by 2. So we have pi over 3 plus 2 pi over 3. So we're taking half of 3 pi over 3. Now, of course, that's pi, so this is just pi over 2. We know from experience that one of the things we're going to want to do with all of these x values is write them with a common denominator. We have a denominator of 6, 3, and 2, so our common denominator will be 6. So 0, nothing to do there, is still going to be 0. Pi over 6 already has our common denominator, so we can just bring it on over. Pi over 3, we're going to want to write as 2 pi over 6. Pi over 2, we're going to want to write as 3 pi over 6. And 2 pi over 3 is 4 pi over 6. That will make our graphing a lot easier when all of our x values have the same denominator. And it also lets you double check to see that you've done all of these calculations correctly, because it should go up by pi over 6 every time. So 1 pi over 6, 2 pi over 6, 3 pi over 6, 4 pi over 6. You're feeling pretty good that you've done that correctly. Next, we turn our attention to our expected y values. Because this is a sine graph, we expect sine graph to behave starting at 0, then going to 1, then going to 0, then going to negative 1, and then going to 0. We know that the function that we're graphing here is y equals negative 2 sine of 3x. So we know that a is equal to negative 2. So then every y value is going to have to get multiplied by that negative 2. So our y values become 0, negative 2, 0, positive 2, and 0. Because 1 times negative 2 is negative 2, negative 1 times negative 2 is positive 2. Now remember, you always have to check at least one value, and don't check one of the roots. Check one of the non-roots. So let's just go ahead and check this value and see if this is going to work out. So we're going to take pi over 6, and we have to plug that in for x in our equation. So we have negative 2 times the sine of 3 times pi over 6, which becomes negative 2 times the sine. 3 pi over 6 reduces to pi over 2. So this equals negative 2 times 1, right? The sine of pi over 2 is 1. So this equals negative 2. And indeed, it checked out. So we're feeling pretty confident that these are the 5 key points of our graph. And now we're ready to head back up to the graph and go ahead and plot this. We can see that our x scale is going to go by pi over 6s. So we've got pi over 6 here, 2 pi over 6, 3 pi over 6, and 4 pi over 6. Or as I've mentioned before, if you prefer to write the reduced forms of these x values, that's fine too. Our y values get as small as negative 2 and as big as positive 2, and I like to use as much of the graph as I can, spread it out so I can see it better, so I might be tempted to have my y scale go every 2 dotted lines. You don't have to, but it's just a suggestion. And now we're ready to plot our graph. We know the graph starts out at 0, 0, then it goes to pi over 6, negative 2, then 2 pi over 6, 0, 3 pi over 6, 2, and 4 pi over 6, 0. We connect with smooth curves. Remember, no straight lines anywhere ever. And there's our graph of y equals negative 2 sine of 3x. Now remember, we said that negative sign right here was going to make the graph flip over the x-axis, and we're seeing that that's true. So normally sine would go root max, root min, root, but instead, because it's flipped over, it's going to go root min, root max, root. Now we have to solve an equation to find all the x-intercepts and then use it to find three roots. And just another reminder that x-intercepts, roots, and zeros are used interchangeably. Now, to solve the equation to find the x-intercepts, remember that we're going to take the argument of the function and set it equal to the place where the normal x-intercepts happen for sine. Our argument is equal to 3x, and looking at the summary chart we made for sine and cosine, we see that normally the roots of sine occur at n pi. Remember that n is an integer, so the only thing we need to do here is divide each side by 3, and our formula for the roots is going to be x is equal to n pi over 3. Next, we have to use this formula to find three roots of the function. So we're going to pick values for n, and we'll find out where the roots are. So we could go negative 1, 0, and 1. You could pick any integer you want. You could say 0, 1, 2. You could pick 10, 11, 12. I'm picking what I think are the easiest ones to plug in, which is negative 1, 0, and 1. Now, if we plug negative 1 in for n, we can see we're going to get negative 1 times pi over 3. So that's negative pi over 3. If we plug in 0 for n, we're going to get x equals 0. And if we plug in 1 for n, we're going to get x is equal to pi over 3. And we could use this formula to find the infinitely many roots that go on forever and ever in the positive direction on the graph and forever and ever in the negative direction on the graph. And if we look at our graph, we can see that we did have a root at 0, and we have a root at pi over 3, which is the 2 pi over 6. And if we were to plug in n is equal to 2, then we would get that last root in our graph, which is at 2 pi over 3.